Secretary of State Hillary Clinton remains in a New York hospital this morning after doctors discovered a blood clot that formed near her brain. She's being treated with blood thinners and will be in the hospital until the right dose can be worked out.
Clinton suffered a concussion when she fainted and fell in mid-December. Her doctors say she's expected to make a full recovery.
She's making excellent progress, they say, and lucky that they found that in a routine MRI.
Doctors in New York giving some new details about the condition of Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She's in the hospital being treated for a blood clot that formed in her brain, the latest problem in a month of health trouble. ABC's Martha Raddatz has more on this.
The normally globetrotting Secretary of State is in a hospital room, monitored closely and being given blood thinners to break up the clot. Family members, including daughter Chelsea, have been at her side. The clot was discovered on an MRI on Sunday, a statement from her doctors saying the scan revealed a clot in the vein that is situated in the space between the brain and the skull, behind the right ear. The statement says the secretary did not suffer a stroke or any neurological damage, but this is clearly a serious setback. It was December 7th when the secretary was last seen in public during an overseas diplomatic tour where she picked up a bad stomach virus. Days later, still ill, the secretary fainted and got that nasty concussion. Clinton has had a blood clot in the past, in 1998, behind her right knee after a year of heavy travel. This clot comes at the end of the most demanding period of her life. As she recently told ABC's Barbara Walters.
Are you exhausted?
I am. To be honest, I am. Because when I do something, I really want to do it. I want to do it to the best of my ability. That means I pretty much work all the time.
But what is unclear is whether she will be able to return to her full-time role at the State Department before a new Secretary of State is sworn in.
Clinton's doctors say she will be released from the hospital once the proper medication dose is determined. They do say she is making excellent progress, and they're confident she will eventually make a full recovery. She is reportedly in good spirits, engaging with her doctors, her family, and her staff. Martha Raddatz, ABC News, Washington.
It's good, though, that the clot did not cause a stroke or any neurological damage, and they found it during a routine MRI, and it formed, it was very rare that this actually formed out of a concussion. The New England Journal of Medicine estimates that there are only 4 cases per 1 million people each year, and the fact that you have this sort of ramification following a concussion, but just thankful that they found it when they did.
Could have been fatal, so it's just great, and she's going to make a full recovery, so
she's
thank
an excellent
goodness.
Spirits, as Martha pointed out. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is in the hospital this New Year's morning being treated for a blood clot that formed in her head. Clinton suffered a concussion when she fainted and fell in mid-December, and doctors in New York are now using blood thinners to try to break up the clot. ABC News medical editor Dr. Richard Besser says it's possible that Clinton will need to stay on long-term medication.
I've been talking to a number of neurosurgeons about this, and she had had a clot in her leg once before, and now she has a clot in a large vessel in her head. She will likely have a big workup to see, does she have a problem with clotting in general? And if she does, she might need to be on a medication for that for a much longer period, if not for the rest of her life.
Clinton's doctors say they expect her to make a full recovery, but that she will stay in the hospital until she's on the proper dose of medication. But excellent progress and good spirits.
Really good news there.
Yeah.
Thank goodness they caught this on a precautionary
MRI.
And thank God they did.
Yeah, because typically something like this can lead to a stroke or even worse.
Absolutely. So, the most admired woman in America, according to all the polls. So she's doing well. We're happy for that.
A routine MRI was anything but routine for Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. Her doctors now say it revealed a blood clot in the vein that drains blood from the head. This is likely the result of a fall earlier this month when Mrs. Clinton suffered a concussion. Doctors say there is no evidence of a stroke or any kind of neurological damage, and the secretary is expected to make a complete recovery. Still, very scary when you hear what happened. CNN's Jill Doherty is live at the State Department. Jill, what do we know about her condition right now?
Hey, John. Well, she is stable. She's in the hospital. And the main thing is right now, they're trying to shrink that blood clot by administering medications, these blood thinners. And that's their task right now, is to get exactly how much she needs over what period. They have to work on that because it depends on body weight and everything. When they have that pinned down, then theoretically at that point, they would be able to release her. So it did sound very scary at the beginning, and potentially it is serious, but they seem to have it under control. Luckily, it's not bleeding inside the brain, and that's the important thing. And she's stable, talking with her doctors, talking with her family. In fact, there was a recent tweet, as you just mentioned last hour, a tweet from Chelsea Clinton thanking people for sending their best wishes to her mother. So the prognosis is that she would be, you know, released when they get this, when she's stable and they know how much medication she will need.
Right, Jill Doherty in Washington for us this morning. Thanks very much.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is being treated for a blood clot in her head and is expected to make a full recovery, but that doesn't mean people are not concerned. Joining us live now from the State Department is our foreign affairs correspondent, Jill Doherty. Jill, how long is the secretary expected to be hospitalized? Do we know?
We don't, actually. And the reason we don't is because right now the doctors in New York, we understand, are administering this anticoagulant, a blood thinner, which is designed to kind of dissolve that blood clot that is between her brain and her skull. So once they decide that they have the right combination, you know, the right amount, etc., then they potentially could release her. But they won't really do that until they're sure that they've got it. So at this point, we don't know. Maybe we would hear some more today. They were originally indicating that she would be having this blood thinning, this medication, for about 48 hours, and she went in on Sunday, so that would mean maybe today. But again, not clear. They want to be very, very sure that everything's done correctly.
Do we know if she's working while she's in the hospital? Is she able to?
They haven't said that she is, but she has been described as very engaged with her doctors, her family, her friends who are visiting her. And there would appear to be no impact on her daily life and she's in the hospital, but in her interaction with other people and how she is functioning. And that seems to be, as they say, the prognosis, that if everything goes according to how it's going, she's making very good progress and could make a full recovery. It's actually something that doctors do say she can live a normal life, even if she had to be on this kind of anticoagulant for a while, or maybe for her entire life. But people function with this. It's not, at least at this stage, anything that's life-threatening or could keep her theoretically from carrying out her duties.
But definitely no clue on whether or when she could return to work.
No, we did know even before this happened, you know, after she had the stomach flu, after she had the concussion, that let's say her travel was on hold. They said that she wouldn't be traveling at least, you know, the earliest until the middle of the month, and certainly that would be a obvious prediction that she won't be doing very much traveling. But it really totally depends on how she is feeling. Don't forget that, you know, this came up Sunday night. It was something that was not expected. She was, to all intents and purposes, recuperating from that hitting her head during the bout with the stomach flu, and people thought that she would be back. She certainly did too. So this was a curveball that they have to deal with, and they have to make sure they've got it right.
Now, as far as we know, she's still expected to testify before the Congress on Benghazi. Do we know if this situation is affecting that?
You know, cognitively, I mean, the way she can relate and testify theoretically, again, this is all theoretically, but according to what the doctors are indicating, she should be able to do that. The question would be when and whether they release her and when she decides, and they decide, that she can actually do it. But she has indicated a number of times that she does want to do it. And don't forget, there have been a couple of reports that have been very damning of the State Department. So people in Congress, members of Congress, are saying, we definitely want her to testify. We want her to explain what happened. And then after that, theoretically, you could have the man whom President Obama wants to be the next person in line as Secretary of State. That's John Kerry. He could go through his nominations hearings, and we could move forward. But look where we are. It's 3 weeks before the inauguration. Time is really moving fast.
That's for sure. Thanks so much, Jill Doherty at the State Department. We're all wishing the Secretary the very best.
Since the news broke about Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and the blood clot that was discovered in her head, reporters have been scrambling to find out just how dangerous the rare disorder that she has is. And I just wanted to show you what was in the New York, one of the New York papers today. This is the New York Daily News. It's a picture of Chelsea. You can see it says, Fear for Hill. I'm not sure if a picture says 1,000 words or not, but her family certainly rushed to the New York Presbyterian Hospital where she's being treated, and that Daily News picture really caught that image of what appears to be a distraught Chelsea Clinton. She was leaving the hospital after the visit with her mom, and she also tweeted out a message yesterday afternoon thanking people for their support. Let me just quote for a minute. She said this, thank you to all for sending good thoughts my mom's way, grateful to all her doctors, and that she'll make a full recovery. The doctors for their part say that there's no evidence of a stroke or any neurological damage with regard to this clot that was near her brain. CNN's Jill Doherty is live at the State Department now. So obviously a lot of people want to know how she's doing. Clearly, she has a very important role. Do we know if her progress is getting better, or are they actually keeping us abreast?
You know, they haven't issued anything today, but yesterday, as we know, kind of last night, last evening, they did, her two doctors issued a report, and it was pretty in-depth, at least very technical, explaining precisely where that blood clot was located, what they were doing about, which is giving blood thinners, and that's the whole idea, that you want to shrink it. It's not, I think, actually, it's important to point out, it's not on the brain itself. It's between the brain and the skull, so it's actually kind of an area that, in a way, that vein is isolated from the actual brain, and that would be the danger. That's why they were saying she did not have a stroke, she did not have any neurological problems. So what they do is they shrink that, and using these blood thinners, what they are doing now, we understand, is determining how much to give her, how strong a dose, etc. Depends on the person, it depends on how big or small they are. And then once they determine that, once they have it locked down, that is her recipe, then they potentially can let her leave the hospital. So that's what we're waiting for, you know, some type of indication that the doctors have signed off on this.
And then, Jill, of course, you know, the doctors have said she's expected to make a full recovery. I think a lot of people were buoyed by that, thinking out of concern for the secretary that her health was improving. But then, I mean, I have to be honest, when I saw that picture, I had second thoughts. I just want to hold the shot up again because I was very concerned to see that was Chelsea leaving the hospital, not sort of rushing to the hospital, and that made me concerned for whether we're getting all the information or not. You remember what John Bolton said, the U.S. Right. Former U.N. ambassador, how I want to quote this. He said this was a diplomatic illness to beat the band, alluding to this might be a way to escape testifying on the Benghazi affair. I think clearly we're beyond that now. He hasn't apologized for that, but I think we're beyond feeling like this is a diplomatic illness. But do we know how serious this could be?
Well, if you talk to doctors, what they've been saying is, potentially, if this were not treated, it could be dangerous because it could lead to a buildup of blood in the head, and that could have an impact on the brain. So, yes, potentially, if it were not treated. But luckily, it was found, and it is being treated, and apparently she's doing well. So if you also talk to doctors, they say that the prognosis of living a normal life is very good, that you would probably have to continue with some type of blood thinners, but a lot of people do that, and, you know, she can go on.
But driven, though. It makes me wonder if she's able to work in her hospital bed or if she is absolutely not supposed to. I don't know if they have released any of that kind of information.
They haven't. We have no pictures, and they haven't said whether she's, you know, got her briefing books in the bed mm-hmm. with her. But we do know that they said that she was interacting with her doctors, talking with her family and her friends who had come to the hospital in New York to visit her. So it sounds as if, you know, cognitively she's fine, and she she's, you know, chatting away. Whether she can really, you know, sustain some type of schedule, doctors would have to determine that. But long term, they're saying it shouldn't really have an effect on what she does, her job as Secretary of State.
Well, we certainly all wish her the best, and thank you, Jill, for keeping tabs on that for us. Happy New Year.
Same to you.
New details on Hillary Clinton's health scare. The Secretary of State is being treated with blood thinners to help dissolve a blood clot discovered in her head. The clot is located in the vein between the brain and the skull, and it's just behind her right ear. The doctors at New York Presbyterian Hospital say they're confident she will make a full recovery. Her daughter Chelsea echoed that positive outlook in a tweet, saying, quote, "Thank you to all for sending good thoughts my mom's way. Grateful to all our doctors and that she will make a full recovery." CNN Chief Medical Correspondent Dr. Sanjay Gupta has more on the possible dangers Mrs. Clinton faces. Sanjay?
We do have some new details about what happened to Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, specifically where this blood clot is located. You remember before we knew that she had a blood clot, she was getting blood thinning medication, and we could surmise from that that the blood clot itself wasn't located on top of the brain, because if it was actually pushing on the brain, blood thinning medication would worsen that, make that pressure on the brain even worse. Let me show you here by way of model. First of all, this is on the right side of her head, but for this demonstration, I'm going to show you the left side of the head for this model. Here you have the brain. Again, if the blood clot was actually pushing on the brain, you wouldn't give blood thinning medication. But rather, in this case, the blood clot is located in one of the blood vessels inside the brain, a blood vessel that typically drains blood away from the brain. It's called the sinus here, and in her case, it's actually in this area over here, the transverse sinus, again, on the right side of her brain. This is a pretty rare condition. This is something that doesn't happen often, but it needs to be treated with blood thinning medications to try and make that clot dissolve. Here's the concern. You have blood going to the brain. That blood also needs to leave the brain. If that blood is not leaving the brain, the pressure in the brain can start to build up, and that's what you don't want to happen. Most likely, you know, in the Secretary's case, they will need to get another scan at some point to actually show that the clot, this blood clot inside that blood vessel, has in fact gone away. Doctors, very, very important to point out, they have said, look, she has had no stroke from this, which is a potential complication. She, in fact, they say that she's had no neurological impact whatsoever. I've heard from sources that if you were to see her, you wouldn't know that this sort of problem was going on. But again, a rare occurrence, a cerebral venous clot, cerebral venous thrombosis it's called, being treated with blood thinners in the hospital right now. As we get more information, we'll certainly bring it to you. Back to you.
All right, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, thanks so much.
So Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, as you know, is spending another night in the hospital as doctors treat a blood clot in her head. We're going to try to find out what we can about her condition. Dr. Sanjay Gupta, who of course is a neurosurgeon, is going to join us ahead. Welcome back. Tonight, doctors are keeping a careful eye on Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, who remains hospitalized for a blood clot near her brain. She was admitted to New York Presbyterian Hospital on Sunday, just as she was preparing to return to work after suffering a concussion in mid-December. It was during a follow-up exam for that concussion that her doctors discovered the blood clot. This is not the first time she's been treated for a clot like this. In 1988, while First Lady, she developed a blood clot in her leg. This time, the clot is in a vein in her head. Her doctors say they're confident she'll make a full recovery. Our chief medical correspondent, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, who's a neurosurgeon, joins me now. So a blood clot in the head sounds very serious, no?
Yeah, you know, the big distinction here is you want to know, is this clot inside a blood vessel or is it not? That's the first question doctors are going to ask. If it's outside a blood vessel, meaning that the blood vessel is actually ruptured or opened up for some reason, and you're basically accumulating blood outside of the vessel, that's a bigger problem. Mm-hmm. Let me show you in this model really quickly. Let's say you had a blood clot that was actually on top of the brain, and it was putting pressure on the brain. That would obviously be a problem, maybe even something that would require surgery. Most importantly, you wouldn't want to give blood thinners. That would make that problem worse, mm-hmm. and would also burn a bridge in terms of possibly performing surgery, should mm-hmm. she need it. In her case, let me show you here, Anderson. She actually has a blood clot inside one of the blood vessels. It's in a vein that actually drains blood away from the brain. So take a look here. I think you can see this blue area in here. Those are veins, and these veins take blood away from the brain. In her case, this is the left side. In her case, on the right side, but just for the sake of this model, it's right about here. Mm-hmm. That's where that vein is. A clot is in that area in her case. Think of it like this. You got blood going to the brain, that same blood eventually has to leave. If it's not leaving, the pressure starts to build up in the brain, and that's what the doctors are most concerned about. That could lead to a stroke or some other problem.
By the way, I think I misspoke. I said 88. I think it was 98 when she had the original blood clot. So how is this treated? I think they're giving her blood thinners now.
They give her blood thinners, and they hope that it eventually, by thinning the blood, that clot will start to dissolve, and then it'll eventually open up and allow the blood to start to drain. That can take some time, and this issue that you bring up about that blood clot in 98, it sort of gives doctors this idea that she is just one of these people who be maybe more likely to form clots.
And why are some people more likely?
We're constantly in a state of clotting and not clotting in our body. You're doing it right now, I'm doing it right now. Some people tip the balance a little bit more towards clotting.
Clotting is?
Clotting, just forming blood clots, within the blood. So the blood is constantly circulating, but you can get little clots. Like if you cut yourself.
Grouping of hardened blood or something?
Like if you cut yourself, you'll notice a clot that forms around the cut. It's the same sort of thing, except it's happening inside the blood vessel. So she may be somebody who's more likely to clot, and as a result of that, and now this particular problem, she may need to be on these blood thinners for an even longer
period
of time.
And if that doesn't work?
If that doesn't work, that's a very interesting question, Anderson. They do want to open up that particular blood vessel. So what you may need to do in these situations, if the blood thinners aren't working, is actually put a little catheter, literally threaded all the way up into the brain. It's quite an extraordinary procedure. You go through the area just in the leg.
From the leg all the way through to the head.
You're threading it all the way up.
Why do you have to go so far?
Well, it's one of these blood vessels you can access pretty easily. Uh-huh. You have to find somewhere where you can get into the body, easily and safely. And then you thread that up, and then you can actually put some of that medication right on the clot directly.
That's crazy.
Try and break
that they
it
can
up.
Do that. That's amazing.
Yeah, and get this. If that doesn't work, sometimes what they'll do is they'll literally take this corkscrew type device, put it into the clot, corkscrew, and then pull the whole clot all the way out of the body.
Wow.
It's a pretty extraordinary thing. Thankfully, you don't have to do it very often. And I should say, this problem that we're describing in general is a pretty rare thing.
Is that a risky thing, though, putting that thing in?
It is risky. It's a challenging procedure, and it's risky because these veins, this vein that I'm describing, it's a thin-walled structure, so you don't want to tear it.
How much room are you talking about? How thin are they?
The blood vessel itself is pretty tiny, but the wall is really thin. It's like a piece of cheese. So if you were, you don't want to cut it or open it up in some way, because that would obviously cause even more.
So when you're threading it, how do you not just poke through the wall?
You're literally threading it and watching this monitor simultaneously, and basically guiding it by watching the monitor.
That's incredible.
Yeah, people train for years to do that sort of thing.
Wow, amazing. Well, obviously we wish you the best. Sanjay, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Amazing.
What about the Secretary of State, her dangerous blood clot, what could that mean for Hillary Clinton and her political future? I'm Wolf Blitzer, you're in the Situation Room. News of a blood clot between Hillary Clinton's brain and her skull raising new questions about her future right now. She was already expected to step aside as Secretary of State, but she's a leading presidential contender for 2016 if she chooses to run again. So how will her current health crisis potentially impact her future? Seeing as Mary Snow is joining us now. Mary, first of all, what's the latest on the Secretary's condition?
Well, we haven't heard from her doctors since yesterday when they updated her condition, disclosing the details of the blood clot that put Secretary of State Hillary Clinton in the hospital on Sunday, saying that she's making excellent progress. Now, an expert in blood clots told us, if unrelated, these clots could be serious, but he said the fact that it's being addressed is a good sign. On the day when Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was supposed to be getting ready to return to work, she spent another day at a New York hospital. Her doctors say they are treating her with blood thinners after discovering a blood clot in the vein between the brain and skull behind the right ear. They expect her to make a full recovery and say she did not suffer stroke or neurological damage. Dr. Jack Ansell is not involved in Secretary Clinton's case, but has treated cases like hers and calls them rare. He's the chairman of the Department of Medicine at Lenox Hill Hospital.
What does this mean for the future?
I think her future is as good as her past. She should recover from this. She will be treated with blood thinners. I can't say how long because I don't know all of the circumstances, but certainly a minimum of 3 to 6 months, may well be longer. Could, in some rare cases, could be lifelong. But many patients are on blood thinners for life for other conditions. She should recover fully and get back to work.
And that work is grueling. Hillary Clinton has traveled to more than 100 countries as Secretary of State and logged close to 1 million miles during that time. Dr. Ansel says while travel is something to watch out for among people who suffer blood clots, most often in the leg veins, which Mrs. Clinton did have in the late 1990s, he doesn't see her travel schedule being an impediment.
I think the travel is probably more an issue of, with the blood clot that she had back about 12 years ago in her leg. And so anybody who has had a blood clot, they're always at risk for developing another one, and the risk is probably a little greater than if they never had a blood clot. So I think travel is potentially an issue for the secretary, but I would imagine that when she travels, she's not sitting in a coach seat cramped up and sitting still.
Secretary Clinton is planning to step down as President Obama's second term begins. While she has repeatedly said she is not interested in running for president again, she is viewed as the Democratic favorite in 2016 should she choose to run.
Well, we wish her, of course, a speedy, speedy recovery. Mary, thanks very much. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton remains in a New York City hospital being treated with blood thinners to dissolve a clot in her head. Her doctors say they're confident the secretary will make a full recovery, but it is a dangerous condition. Joining us now is Dr. David Deaton, a vascular surgeon at Georgetown University Hospital here in Washington. Dr. Deaton, thanks very much for coming in. We know the best case scenario is she gets healthy in a few days, she's out of there, she resumes her lifestyle, may take some medication for a while to deal with the problem. What's the worst case scenario, though?
Well, the worst case scenario, of course, for all of us is death. But the
what do you mean when you say death? This is a life-threatening disease,
no,
potentially?
I'm referring to the worst case and for all of us on this planet.
Yeah.
But in this case, the worst case, it's hard to define. It doesn't seem like there is really a very bad case scenario because she doesn't seem to have presented with any neurologic symptoms. This was a finding made on an imaging study, and that's a very different situation than if you present with severe neurologic symptoms, which have not been reported.
And she's taking medication to deal with the clot. I understand that the medication, correct me if I'm wrong, you know a lot about this, it doesn't necessarily directly make the blood clot go away, but it prevents it from getting bigger.
That's correct. There is a class of drugs that we use to actively break up clot, but your body's own physiology has a way to break up clots. And the medications that she's receiving, anticoagulants, simply augment the body's natural system of resolving thromboses.
Because the worst case, if, God forbid, this blood clot went into her brain, then you got major problems, neurological problems, potentially a stroke. So you got to monitor it pretty closely. How do you do that?
Well, there's no real risk of this blood clot going into her brain. Remember, this is in the venous system going away from her brain, and they can't sort of move upstream. But all anticoagulant therapies have a risk of bleeding, so that's the primary complication from blood thinners or anticoagulants.
Do they all work the same ways on individuals, or every individual has a different sort of DNA that allows these anticoagulants to work in a different way?
Well, that's the art of treating people with thrombotic problems, is that we all are different and we have different genetic backgrounds, and so the medication has to be regulated in a very different way based on an individual basis.
Do we know if this blood clot started, some people thought I was wrong, I assumed it started as a result of the head injury she suffered. She had a bad flu, she was dehydrated, she fainted, she fell, and she got a concussion, and I assume the concussion led to this blood clot, but other people are now saying maybe the stomach virus and the dehydration led to the blood clot. In your experience, what would be the more logical cause of this blood clot?
There's not usually a way to pin, you know, the cause and effect on a blood clot, but certainly dehydration, any inflammatory state, any trauma, such as a fall, all can be contributing factors to a blood clot, and including a underlying predisposition to blood clots.
Because I know blood clots in the leg, the deep vein thrombosis that unfortunately killed my old friend David Bloom of NBC News during the war in Iraq. He was in a sedentary sitting position inside an armored vehicle for a long period of time. That apparently contributed to that. She's on a plane a lot, but you know, she's got a little cabin there. She can move around if she wants. She's not in a coach seat, if you will. But how much of a problem are these blood clots resulting from a sedentary position?
Well, venous thromboembolism is an enormous health problem in the United States. $5 to $8 billion are spent on dealing with that problem. But it occurs because of dehydration, because of stasis. So it's a complication often after
surgery. Stasis meaning?
Just not moving. We depend on the muscles in our legs to push the blood back towards our heart. So if we don't, the blood pools there. And that's the classic setup for a venous thrombosis.
All right, so let's talk about recommendations to our viewers who are watching. They don't want blood clots in the legs, in the lungs, in the head, any place. What advice do you have for people who are watching right now?
Well, the classic situation, the one that most hear about, is the airliner situation. And that's because on an airliner, you often sit in a position for a long time. You may not get up and move around. And that air has no humidity in it at all. So you do get dehydrated, particularly on longer flights.
So you should drink a lot of fluid.
Right.
Even if it means getting up and going to the bathroom.
Well, you simply need to move your legs around. This applies to whether you're riding in a car, a military vehicle, than David Bloom's case, or an airplane. But generally speaking, it's not an enormous problem if you pay attention to it. But just move your leg muscles.
Make sure you're not dehydrated. Move around a little bit, and just those are the best reasons.
Right. When your legs are in a dependent position, you need to move your legs around a little bit.
Bottom line is you're upbeat. You're encouraged by the statement that Hillary Clinton's doctors put out. When they said Secretary's making excellent progress, we are confident she will make a full recovery. That sounds good to you.
Everything that we've been told about her condition would lead us to believe that she'll have a full recovery with no problems or resulting from this event.
Because she did have a history of that one blood clot behind her knee years ago.
Yes, and she probably will need to have a workup, a series of blood tests to see if she is hypercoagulable or if she has a predisposition to blood clots, which a number of people in the U.S. have. It's not an uncommon condition, and that changes the strategy for long-term therapy.
Dr. Deaton of Georgetown University, thanks very much for coming in.
Absolutely.
Appreciate your expertise.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton remains in the hospital tonight. She's being treated with blood thinners to dissolve a blood clot in her head. Margaret Brennan is at New York Presbyterian Hospital. Margaret, what are we hearing about her health tonight?
Well, Anthony, Secretary Clinton's spokesperson says that he'll share new information when there is something to update. When Clinton was hospitalized on Sunday, that same spokesperson said that doctors would monitor her for about 48 hours. We're now beyond that window, but doctors tell us that it usually takes more than 2 days to establish the proper dose of blood thinner and weeks, even months, to thin out the clot. Treatment can last up to 6 months.
The Secretary has about 3 weeks left in office. I mean, essentially, has her term ended now then?
Well, the secretary was expected to step down at the end of the month once the Senate confirms her successor. But today, Senate staffers told us that right now there is no word yet as to when Congress will begin those hearings to approve John Kerry as the next Secretary of State. Clinton herself isn't expected to travel. These health issues have kept her from all public events for the past 3 weeks, but she is working from her hospital bed.
Margaret Brennan at New York Presbyterian Hospital. Thank you, Margaret.
There's one thing Democrats and Republicans can agree on. As of today, Hillary Clinton would be an unstoppable candidate if she runs for president in 2016.
Elise, you travel with the Secretary of State, you watch her work, you see the pace she keeps. This is a tireless woman, not used to slowing down.
Definitely not, Don. This is a woman who we can't even keep up with her. There's the pace that she goes, especially on the road, but also here in Washington, is really relentless. There is not someone who just flies and meets in a foreign ministry with a leader or a president and has a dinner. This is someone who's constantly going on the road, meeting with civil society groups, meeting with opposition groups, having town halls. Someone who really doesn't slow down. And, you know, the last few years, Secretary Clinton always has been someone that keeps a frantic pace, even when she was first lady, when she was senator. But the last few years, Don, she's really been going at a kind of frantic pace. They call her the ever-ready bunny.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us. TeHillaryClinton.com.
Sometimes, you know, the journalists that travel with her can't even keep up with her. She's always, you know, got some other group to visit, some other place to go, some other event, and sometimes we could travel to 3 countries in a day. I mean, this is someone who really puts the pedal to the metal. I think just the pace of the last 4 months, you know, everyone's been wondering, is she going to run for president in 2016? And when you ask her whether she's going to, she says, I mean, a lot of people don't necessarily believe her, but she says no. And I think one of the things is that even if she believes it right now, I think a lot of people think she just needs some rest, she needs to slow down. And there have been people that have been worried about the kind of the pace that she's taking, because this is not someone who's saying, no, I can't do that. This is someone who's, to her staff, is saying, come on, we can fit one more thing in, we can fit one more meeting in, we can fit one more country in. Sometimes I travel to 3 countries in a day with Secretary Clinton.
Well, Secretary Clinton was, you know, as you well know, she really moved. She was constantly on the go. She never stopped. She went to all these countries. I think she broke all sorts of records. I know that Madeleine Albright and Condoleezza Rice and Colin Powell, they traveled a lot as Secretary of State. But I think Hillary Clinton broke all sorts of records. She worked really hard, and I had a chance to spend a little time on one of those trips. She went to France, then Egypt, then Tunisia. I accompanied her on her plane, watched what was going on. She was nonstop. She took that kind of aggressive, nonstop travel from her, to a certain degree, from her husband, the former President Bill Clinton. I traveled with him all the time, and he was nonstop as well. He used to do day trips. We used to joke to Bosnia or Kosovo or whatever, and Hillary Clinton was like that. She moved, she moved, she moved.
And we know as well, Secretary Clinton, when she was the First Lady, traveled quite a bit as well around the world.
A new Gallup poll found that President Obama is the most admired man in America. Is this our first poll of the new year? For the fifth straight year. And the same poll found the most admired woman, Hillary Clinton. Guess how many years in a row? 11.